Hello friends, welcome back to GK Code Labs. Today we are going to start a new interview question series for big data. So any of my friends who are planning to go into big data domain and preparing for big data interviews, I request you to please subscribe to my channel, because this interview question series along with the other videos on GK Code Labs will surely help you in getting through the big data interviews. So today we are going to see one of the most frequently asked question in big data interviews, and also one of the most important use cases that many of the big data projects apply in their business logic, which is how to handle incremental data load. So today we are going to see this, how to handle the same in Apache Hive. So this is basically what we are going to see today. Suppose we have an input directory or a staging directory, you can say. And from the business upstream, we are getting daily data in form of files. Suppose day 1 we got one file, day1.csv. Day 2 again same kind of file. Maybe this day 2 file could have new data or some of the changes in the data that we got in day 1. Similarly, we are going to get similar kind of files daily. So now our scenario is, we have to read all this data on the daily basis, and we have to analyze the incremental load. Incremental load in a sense, what new data we have and what changes in the previous data we have. So we'll analyze this incremental or the delta data in Hive, and finally we will create a view which will show us the final incremented data. So without any further ado, let's go and create this code. So I've opened my Cloudera Quick Start VM. Now let me show you a sample data that I am going to use for this. Suppose this is day1.csv. This is the day 1 file that we have received. We have the employee ID, name, phone, city, email and the modified date. Suppose the first file I have got for 20th April. So this is the 5 employees data that we have with their unique employee ID. So let's quickly fire up the Hive. I'll zoom it a bit. Okay, so our Hive is up and running. Before moving any further, let's put this file, whatever data set we have, into our HDFS, as by default our Hive reads from the HDFS. Let me open another session. So I already have the datasets directory. I'll check what I have in this. Okay, incremental load. So inside incremental load Hive directory, I'm going to put my dataset 1. My dataset was inside my desktop. So for putting, we will use Hadoop command, Hadoop fs-put. day1.csv into this directory. Now I have data in my I have data inside my dataset directory. So let's go ahead and create our Hive table. I have already prepared a query depending upon my input file, EMP ID, EMP name, phone, city, email, modified date. Our data is separated by comma, and all the data is inside our HDFS directory, inc load Hive. As all my files have the header, so I'll mention the table properties, skip header line count 1. So from top 1, it will exclude that and load into the table, as we want to load the employee details, not the column names. So let's go ahead and create this in Hive shell. So as you can see, I can say show tables. I have an inc table inside. Let me show you what all data I have in this. So all the data that was inside my data set has been loaded. All the data has come on 20th April. Now let's do one thing. Let's create another data set. Suppose we'll make that data like we have received in second day. So I'll create another data set. Day2.csv. Now let's say for top 3 employees I'll provide the changes. Suppose the city of first employee Arpit changes to _updated. So we are, city is updated. For the next employee, let's update the email ID. For third employee, let's update the city. Anything could change. Also, in the second day, let's introduce 2 new employees. So our employee ID 4 and 5 were already there. So 5, suppose 7 and 8. I am introducing 2 new employees. EMP1, EMP2. Phone number, anything you can change or let it be. City can be same. EMP, email ID, I'll introduce new one. So all this data is for 21st. So let me change the date for everyone, because we are getting this in day 2. So all this data we are getting on 21st April, next day. That is why it is day 2. So as you can see, in day 2 we have updates for 3 employees that we already updated in day 1, and we are introducing 2 new employees. So let me go ahead and place this file again in HDFS. -put day2.csv to the same directory. Okay, so now data is there. As you know, we have created external table which is mapped to this directory where we have been uploading the data sets. So it will automatically pick up all the data which is there in all the files inside this directory. So for example, I have not changed anything. I'll just run the same query again. You can see the output. If you can see, first data set, five outputs are there. Second data sets, again 5 outputs are there, with first 3 employee as updated and 2 new employees. So as expected, we have introduced 2 data sets. Now what we need is the incremental data. Incremental data, in a sense, if employee ID 1, this employee, if it has some updates, we need this one. We need to ignore the first one, correct? So similarly, first 3 employees, old data, we do not need. We need the updated data. But also where we have not got any update, we need that employee. Also, whatever new employees have been introduced, we need their data also. So this will be finally our incremental load output. So for that, let me try to create a query that would serve our purpose, and then finally we can create a view or a external table again that will serve our purpose. So as we have all our data in our INC table, let's first select all the records that is in our INC table. Select star from INC table. Now what we need all the data from our INC table, but only single record for an employee. All inside that, whatever modified date is latest, that record we need to select. So let's give it an alias as T1 and have a join from another same table, but here let's give it alias as T2. But from here we just need the employee ID on which we are going to group it and the maximum modified date. So select EMP ID and max of modified date. Let's give it a alias again, like max modified. This we'll select from the second alias, and also we need only single row for each employee, so we'll do group by EMP ID. So we are going to join T1 and this. So for entire thing I'll give a alias as S anything, and we have to join on T1.EMPID, because EMPID is unique key, that should be equal to S.EMPID. And the modified date should be whatever the max modified date we are getting from the S. T1 dot modified date equal to S dot max modified, because we have given it the alias. And from this entire join we need all the records, so we'll do select T1 dot star from. So this should be our query. Join, let me see. Okay, I think this bracket is already closed here. So let's go ahead and run this query and see what we get. Hive on the backend runs on MapReduce. As you can see, mapper and reducers are working, so it takes some time. So here you can see we are getting only the updated records. See, here city was updated, here email ID was updated, here city was updated again. Only the updated records for the first three employees we are getting. Also, whatever non-updated records were there, they are present as it is, and the new employee records are also there. So this was our final requirement. Now simply what we can do on the same query, we can create a view or a table or a hive table, anything as per your business requirement. We can just to shorten our work, we can create a view suppose final view as this. We'll run this again. So now whenever we are going to select everything from final view, we are going to get the updated or the incremental load output. I'll give you one more demo. Suppose I'm going to create day 3 file. Let's create a day 3 file. In this one, let's update the data for first employee with his surname also, and we'll not provide any other input, only single employee input will be there. And let's put this day 3 also to the same Hive directory. So remember, in day 3 we have got update for only one employee, and no other employee is touched. Let's go in Hive and just select star from our view. So here you can see we have got the output and only the first employee's name is changed. Rest, no matter, on the third day we didn't get any update for any other employee, but all the data is as it is. Only the incremental data for the first employee has got updated, and from this view we can use it as per our requirement, or we can create a new table or use this same data for any other operation. So in this video you got to learn how to handle the incremental data using Apache Hive. We are going to explain many such important use cases which are usually asked in the big data interviews. So I request you to please subscribe to my channel and follow this big data interview series. Also, if you are interested in Spark streaming and Kafka pipelines for live data streaming and other big data concepts, you can go through all those videos on my channel. And please let me know in the comment section below if you want video on any specific use case scenario using any of the big data technologies. So thank you everyone for being with us. Take care.